My name is Ibra with Zoom, and today I will be showing you how to download and install SmartPSS in your computer. So the first thing you want to do is open up a browser and go to our website, which is zoom.life. Once you're in our website, you will need to go to products at the very top. And depending if you're downloading this software for your NVR or your XVR, it doesn't matter. As long as you follow the steps in the videos, you will be able to download the software and use it for either or. In this example, I'm gonna be clicking on NVR. Under NVR, I'm gonna click on 4-channel, and I'm just gonna click on the one that shows no hard drive. Now under here, we need to click on resources and scroll all the way towards the bottom. You'll see software firmware. Here you'll see CMS for Windows, CMS for Mac. You download according to your computer. In my case, I will need to download for Windows. And I'm gonna save as in a specific location so I know exactly where it saves and downloads to in case I need to go back to look at it. I know exactly where it's at. So you can see the downloading has started. And I do want to apologize in advance in case it reacts a little slow. My network is slow at the moment, so just bear with me. Once it has finished downloading, we are going to open up the folder. And you can see it's in a compressed file, so we need to extract. So right click, extract all. Once it has finished extracting, we need to open up SmartPSS, so double click. I'm not sure if you can see this message, but what it shows is, do you want to allow this app from an unknown publisher to make changes to your device? You will need to click yes. And we have the wizard for SmartPSS. So we are going to select the language, English, and we need to check this box here and click next. On this box, it's really important to just check SmartPSS. We do not need to install storage service. So uncheck that and click next. And we need to click install. It has been successfully installed. So I'm gonna click run SmartPSS and click finish. Since I did click run SmartPSS, it should shortly pull up right now here at the bottom. Let's just give it a couple of seconds. So you can see it has now pulled up. Let's click on it. So when you first open up SmartPSS for the first time, it does require you to create a password for it. This is in case you share your laptop or computer with somebody else and you don't want them to have access to this software. You create a password for it. So in case they try opening up the software, it requires them to input the password and they're not allowed in. So let's go ahead and input our password. You have to make sure it reaches the middle strength or else it will not allow it. So just keep that in mind. And also make sure you remember your password and you write it down. We do not have a default password. So in case you forget your password, you will need to delete the software and reinstall it and do everything again. And it's just going to be a hassle. So just remember your password and write it down. And in case you don't share your laptop or computer with anybody else, like in my case, all you have to do is auto log in after registration, and it's not going to require that password. So when SmartPSS first pulls up, you're going to see this pop-up screen. Just going to click out of it, and automatically it pops you up on the devices screen. I will close this out, go in further detail later on in the video. This is the main screen of SmartPSS. Some of the main functions you will be using is live view, playback, devices, and user, in case you want to add a user to this software. So I want to start off by adding a device to our SmartPSS software. So we're going to go to devices. Under devices, we are going to select add here, right under SmartPSS. We need to name our device. So after we name our device, here in the method to add, we're going to click the down menu, and we're going to select SN for serial number, so we can input the P2P information. So let's go ahead and input this information in. Under group name, we're going to leave it as it is. Username, admin, password. This is the password that you created for your device. So we got to click add once you have everything inputted. Make sure you inputted everything correctly, or else it's going to give you a fail or an invalid username or password error. So just give it a couple of seconds. We need to wait for the status to change to online, and there you go. In case your status does not show online, make sure you inputted everything correctly. You didn't mistake a number for a letter, or you inputted the wrong password. If you did, all you have to do is click this little pencil icon and modify it. Do your changes that you may need to do. So once you're online, it shows you your device, the name, the model number, the type. In this case, it's an NVR, and all that cool stuff. So real quick, now that we're here, I want to show y'all that once you do add a device, SmartPSS does allow you to do some certain configurations to that device. So if you click on this little gear icon right next to the pencil, it gives you all of this information like camera, network, event, storage, and system. In case you want to do certain changes, for example, you can update the time, you can change your storage settings, you can set up motion detect through here, and you have other cool feature. So it's a real cool feature just in case you're not on site with the device and you need to do certain changes. You just pull up SmartPSS and it allows you to do that. Also, it does allow you to upgrade your device from here. So you will need to go to our website, download the firmware for your device, depending NVR or XVR. You'll click upgrade, you'll search for that file. So let's just pretend this is that file. You will click open, and I'm just gonna select, just select that one, click open, and it should pull it up here on this little rectangle. And all you gotta do is click firmware upgrade, and you're set. It should start upgrading your firmware. So this is, like I said, it's a cool feature. It allows you to do certain changes to your device. So I'm just going to exit out of this, and go back to the main menu. So now that you have added your device, you would want to view your camera. So you need to go to live view. Here on the left-hand side of the screen, you see your device. If you double-click on it, you should start pulling up your cameras. Depending on your network, on how fast or how slow it is, that's how your cameras are going to pull up. So just be patient with it. As you can see, all four cameras have now pulled up. And let's say you want to view full screen of camera. So you just have to double click on it and it makes it full screen. And to go back, just double click on the screen again and it shows you all four views. Here on the lower right hand side, you see the different layouts depending on how many cameras you would want to add. It shows you the different layouts that are available. So now going back to the main menu. Playback, it's another cool feature. You can view recordings through your computer. So again, you have your device here on the left hand side of the screen. You need to expand it so you can see all of your cameras available. For this example, I'm just going to select this camera. And here towards the bottom, you select your date and your time that you would want to view your cameras. So I'm just going to select the 12th and I'm going to leave it at 12 a.m. and 12:30. So you select your date, your time, and you click OK. Now you have to do is click search and it starts searching for that recording. Once it pulls it up, you just gotta click play. Depending on your network, it might pull up slower or faster. I just want to show you that it does pull up the playback. So moving on, I'm going to close this tab out. So now we have gone over how to add a device, how to live view your device, and how to play back on the device. Now the last thing I want to go over is user. In case you want to add another user to this software and you don't want them to have the admin role, you get to choose here from adding a role to adding a user. So when you add a user, you can name it guest. You set their password and you select the settings that you want them to have access to. And every time they open up the software, they will need to change the user to guest and put their password and so on. I'm going to exit out of this. And I'm going to go back to the main menu. And that is it. This is a quick video showing you how to download and install, as well as a quick rundown of our new software, Smart PSS. I hope this video helps you out. If you have any more questions, please make sure to contact our tech support. Again, I hope this video helps. Thanks for watching.